Shalom, shalom. You highly welcome, my dear brothers and sisters out there. I'm glad that you just clicked to watch this message. Today, I'm going to be talking about delivering thyself, O Zion. And this message is to my brothers and sisters that are being planted in different places of Babylon. You need to be able to understand the world that you are manifested in. And you need to be able to understand the works, the power that is being built in you, that is inbuilt inside of you, my brothers and sisters out there. And why the prophets of old have spoken the word and said to Zion, deliver thyself, O Zion. Deliver thyself, O Zion, that lives among the daughter of Babylon. Now, the Bible said that right from the day of John the Baptist that the kingdom of heaven started suffering violence. And the violent take it by force. You are being planted in the midst of Babylon. And the world that is being run around, that is all surrounding you, is being ruled by wicked forces. The Bible said that what the word was being given into the hand of the wicked. The earth is being given into the hand of the wicked. And so the wicked runs the world. So do you really think that the wicked who runs the world would allow the establishment of the kingdom of heaven on earth? No. So this is the reason why you got to be able to walk in order to deliver thyself from the hand of what of the wicked. Because you are being planted here in order to do what? To usher in the kingdom of heaven on earth. The Bible makes us to be able to understand the words which was being spoken. I want us to go into the book of Matthew before we come back into this particular place. Listen to what the Bible says in the book of Matthew. And that is chapter number 11 from verse number 12. Now, this is what the scripture said. And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. Now ask my brothers and sisters, why do you really think that the kingdom of heaven started suffering violence during the time of John the Baptist? It was as a result of the testimony that John the Baptist gave about Yahushua, which caused a lot of those people who were supposedly supposed to be persecuting John the Baptist now have to have a turnaround. And now they are next and higher enemies to persecute, because that is where things are going to pay them more, are the people who are going after Yahushua, who are going to Yahushua. So this is now another newer dimension of things. So they tend to start persecuting towards the people who are followers of John the Baptist. Now they focus, they put their focus towards the people who are going to bring down the kingdom of heaven on earth. Because you are going to be a threat to them. This is the reason why when Yahushua spoke to them, he was giving them a word that will struck them right there. When he said to them that what's among them that are born of a woman, there has not risen anyone greater than John the Baptist. But you see, greater in the least in the kingdom of Elohim, the least in the kingdom of Yahushua, the least in the kingdom of the Father, those who are coming through Yahushua, the least in the kingdom of Yahushua is going to be greater than John the Baptist. Now, do you understand the mindset of what is really going to usher in the rush, the hatred, the magnitude of pressure that is now going to be going towards those people who are going to be seeking after that kingdom, which is the kingdom where John the Baptist is going to, if is not the least in that kingdom, is greater than John the Baptist? Do you understand the energy, the negative energy that is going to be going after those people? And now, this is what you need to be able to understand, because the world that you are living in is exactly the same thing. The world that you are living in is a world that is being handed over into the hand of the wicked. But the wicked, they see good and they call it evil. And they see evil, they call it good. Now these things are how this world operates. Now you need to be able to understand something in regards to why the Bible says that what arrived from that particular time of John the Baptist, that the kingdom of heaven started suffering violence. You who is a children of Zion, if you are to get yourself freedom, if you want to get your freedom, you don't have to be begging those people who are in the world. Because the world which you are trying to beg them of your own freedom is a corrupt world. So this is why the Bible is saying that if you know what is right for you, the children of Zion, what you do? You take what belongs to you by force. This is your right. You are here to establish the kingdom of heaven on earth. The powers of darkness will not let you to do that, will not allow you. So you got to fight your way through. Now, if you stay, if you know what you are fighting over, it's not that they are not going to come. They are going to come with their pressures. They are going to come with all kind of negative energies towards you. But there's something that you need to be able to bear in mind. That your mission on earth is contrary to the mission of those people who are against you. It's just like negative and positive. So you are on an opposite direction. That is to say, you are going towards the right direction and they are going towards the left direction. So we are talking about taking over, fighting over something which is truly yours. And that thing is not negotiable. You cannot negotiate it with the people who are against you establishing that in their territory. So what you do is to take that what you know by force. And this is what you need to be able to understand, because I see some brethren who think that they can be able to get their freedom by trying to play on the same role, by trying to belong in maybe 501c3, by trying to be able to belong in whatsoever thing that was being constructed by the same system. No, you can't get your freedom there. The Bible is saying that delivered. I said there is no way you can get freedom by, if not first of all, delivering thy own self. The world was being constructed in order to keep people within the same cycle. Listen to what the Bible says. I want us to be able to really go back in order to really see what is really going on. Listen to what the Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter number 11. He said, from verse number 11:12. He said here, verily I say unto you, among them that are born of a woman, there had not risen a greater than John the Baptist. Notwithstanding, he that is least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. Now, I know some of you might not understand the magnitude of this statement, but that is what I just explained to you. Imagine how massively the kingdom of that dark world would fight against the people who are trying to enter into that kingdom, where John the Baptist is not even among the that is literally where John the Baptist is not going to, you know, is going to be, is not even among the least. Literally what the Bible is saying here is that, you know, the least person in the kingdom of heaven is greater than John the Baptist. So imagine the level of John the Baptist which he has come up to. He had his own disciples. He caused a lot of havoc during the time. He gave the dark what he was telling them, what he needed to tell those people, but they never wanted it. And so what happened? They had to be able to do what? To go and do what? And kill the same man. They have to cut his head off. And this was somebody who was being sent to be a record witness about the coming of the one that is more master, that is the master to him, John the Baptist. Which was the reason why John the Baptist gave a testimony and said, the shoe latchet of Yahushua, that he, John the Baptist, is not worthy to do what? To unloose it. So even when the apostles of John the Baptist, you need to be able to understand the magnitude of this now. The apostle, John the Baptist, is somebody who had his own apostles, who had his own, you know, he built up his own thing. That is through the call which he was being called in order to, you know, to be that particular, you know, that particular one that is going to serve as somebody who is going to usher in the greater one. So he had his own disciple. Now the least in the kingdom of Yahushua is greater than John the Baptist. Now what I'm trying to make you to understand is that now understand the magnitude of how the kingdom of darkness is going to be after. If John the Baptist himself was, his head was being chopped off because he said the truth, he exposed that particular word. If John the Baptist was to, his head was chopped off, imagine the level of wickedness. Imagine the level of what is going to happen to those people who are going to be trying to get, who are going to be getting into the kingdom of Yahushua. Imagine what that this wicked world is going to be trying to do to them. You need to be able to understand. So this is the reason why you don't have, you don't need, you don't have to negotiate your freedom with nobody. You take what belongs to you by force. So this is the reason why the Bible said, and from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence. And the violent take it by force. You take what belongs to you by force. What is it that belongs to you? The establishment of kingdom of heaven on earth is by force. You must have to take what belongs to you. This is your right to establish the kingdom of heaven on earth. This is what you are here to do. You don't have to negotiate it with nobody. Now listen to what the Bible say here, because the people that you are trying to negotiate it on with, those people are against you already establishing that kingdom on earth. Now listen to what the Bible say. Let's go into the same book, the book of Luke. I just want us to be able to really see right before we go into that particular place, not into the book of Matthew chapter number 6. Matthew chapter number 6. Now this is what you need to be able to see and understand. Now in verse number 8, chapter number 6 from verse number 9. Now this is what Yahushua said to the people who were his followers. To the people, this is how to pray. Now he's talking about something that is very, very massive. Listen to what the Bible says here. Say, after this manner therefore pray ye, our Father which art. Now when he was praying this prayer, he was not saying something different, but he's saying our Father, which means your Father, my Father. So he was, Yahushua is talking to the people who are going to be building, or who are going to be bringing in this kingdom on earth together with him. He said, this is how you are to pray. Our Father, your Father, my Father, our Father who art in heaven. Now you got to understand why Yahushua has to undergo what he underwent. You know, what he undergone during the time that he manifested. Because he is the master that did what, that showed us the way, and that have, you know, originated the process of establishing this kingdom of heaven on earth, which the kingdom of darkness do not want. And now that you are here, you are playing role by collaborating with Yahushua in order to do what? In order to, you know, establish that kingdom on earth. So the same kingdom of darkness who have been fighting against the establishment of the kingdom of heaven on earth are going to fight against you. And so this is what you need to be able to understand. The Bible said that here. This is how you are to pray. Talking about those people now who are going to be playing the same role of establishing the kingdom of heaven on earth. Because remember, like I said, that this establishment of the kingdom of heaven on earth is non-negotiable. You don't negotiate it with the people who have conspired against you already, who have a conspiracy upon your head. You don't negotiate it with nobody. You are here to be able to do what? To establish the kingdom of heaven on earth. And when you are doing it, you are collaborating together. You are working in perfect harmony. You are working in unison with what? With Yahushua. You are praying together. You are working together. This is the reason why he said, this is how you are to pray. Our Father, your Father, my Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. He said, thy kingdom come. What do you really know and understand by thy kingdom come? What does it mean, thy kingdom come? What is the kingdom of the Father? What is being practiced in the kingdom of the Father? Justice is being practiced in what? In the kingdom of the Father. Equity is being practiced in the kingdom of the Father. Fairness, there is no discrimination in the kingdom of the Father. There is no, you can name it, but all these things are missing in the kingdom, in this particular world. So when he said, when Yahushua said that this is how you are to pray, our Father who art in heaven, your Father, my Father, this is how you are to pray, thy kingdom come. He's saying that bring in, that the coming of these children is going to bring in your own justice. Is going to do what? Is going to rule instead of the unjust that is going on in the world. But the world that you're living in, remember and understand, was being handed into the hand of the wicked. So how can the wicked allow you to establish a just world in the midst of its own, in the midst of the world which was being handed over to into his hand? So in that regard, you got to fight your way through. In that regard, you got to take what belongs to you by force. In that regard, you got to work in order to do what? In order to take that position of establishing that kingdom of heaven on earth. He said there, thy kingdom come on earth as it is what? That will be done on earth as it is in what? In the heavenly places. What is the will of the Father? That what? That justice would rule, right? That is to say, that everything would be done in what? In perfect harmony, in love, in unity, in, you can name them and know that this is, when you go, the Bible talked about, the fruit of the Spirit, which is love, peace, joy, long-suffering, and all these things, which are the characteristics of things which are going to be manifest in that world of the kingdom of the Father. So what I want us to be able to really understand, my dear brothers and sisters out there, is that we are talking about the deliverance of the children, the deliverance of the children of Zion, which are being planted in the midst of Babylon. Because what Babylon has done is that they have already tied so many people. Because the moment that so many people are being tied in the midst of Babylon, what Babylon does is that it blindfold them not to see. This is the reason why you are becoming a threat. Listen to what the Bible says in the book of Psalm chapter number 83. Now listen to what the Bible says, which we are going to read right here in the book of Psalm chapter number 83. Now these are people. These are people who are part of the people that are ruling, or that the word was being committed into their hand. Now listen to what the Bible say. In order for we to be able to really understand the magnitude of how evil and how wicked the construct, the word which was being, which was being constructed, which was being given into the hand of the wicked, how wicked deep it is. Which is the reason why the Bible said to you, for you wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against powers, against rulers of darkness, against spiritual wickedness. This is the scripture. Now listen to the conspiracies. Listen to what has already been done. What has already gone on behalf of a certain people. Because they do not want those people to be able to do what? To awake. Listen to what the Bible say in the book of Psalms 83 from verse number 1. It say here, Psalms, keep not thou silent, O Elohim. Now this is what the Bible is making us to understand. This is what the psalmist is saying. You need to be able to really understand, because at this particular time we're talking about somebody is pleading, is praying, is asking the Father Yahuwah not to keep silent because there is an enemy coming. Listen to what the Bible says: hold not thy peace and be not still, O Elohim, for lo, thine enemy make a tumult. So the Most High Elohim have an enemy, right? Now those enemy hates Yahuwah. And they also, those who hate you, hate your Father already, their children are going to be, they are already on their radar, of course. Now listen to what the Bible say here. It says, for lo, thine enemy make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up their head. They have lifted up their head They have taken a crafty counsel against thy people. So because when you try to get the father, for example, you try to get Yahushua, you couldn't get them. The next thing that you do is to go after those people who are going to be bearing the testimonies, who are going to be bearing the records, who are going to be continuing those things that has already been established right from the day one, who are going to be holding the mantle. So you are going to go after those children because you could not get to the father, you could not get to the son. Now you want to go through and get those children. This is why the Bible says, they have taken a crafty counsel against thy hidden ones and have lifted up their head. Listen to what the Bible says. They have taken a crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden ones. They have said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be, name of Israel, Zion, that the name of Israel, Jerusalem, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance, so that you would not be able to even know that you are in the midst of, in the midst of darkness. They have already encircled you. They have already, they have gone so deep that they do not want you to even visualize the power that you have in you. This is the reason why when I brought you into the book of Matthew chapter number 11, in order to show you how powerful you are in Yahushua. Because if John the Baptist, who is the leader of a people, would be the least in the kingdom of Yahushua. That is, if John the Baptist is not even up to the least in the kingdom of Yahushua, and they persecuted John the Baptist, how do you really know how these people see you? They see you as their greatest threat. And so this is why they have come together and they have planned things out against you. And so this is why the Bible said they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee. And so where the Bible now went on to be able to mention the people who are responsible. And so the Bible said that they've tabernacle of Edom is responsible for this. The Ishmaelites are part of this. The Moabites are part of this. The Hagarites and so on and so forth. These people are all collaborators. These people are people who have come together with one consent. Now, what you need to be able to understand is that in the midst of all this, the Bible said that you need to be able to understand that this world that you are in, you got to deliver thyself, O Zion, that lives in the midst of Babylon. When you look around, you see that the world was already being, corrupted in all fashion and form. Now, what does the Bible make us to understand? Now, listen to what the Bible says. Now, I want us to be able to go right here into the book of Luke chapter number 17. The book of Luke chapter number 17, because it is being corrupted everywhere, so your planting, your position, your being here in the midst of those particular people, you're planting in the midst of those Babylon where you're going to save yourself from. You are coming up in order to build up something which is massive. Listen to what the Bible says, 17:20. Say, and when he was demanded of the Pharisees when the kingdom of Elohim should come, when it should come, he answered them and said, so this is when they wanted to ask him, the Pharisees, right? They wanted to know when the kingdom of Elohim should come. They wanted, these people are hypocrites, right? Now, these are people who are working for the dark world, right? So what does the Bible say? It said, when the kingdom of Elohim should come, he answered them and said, the kingdom of Elohim cometh not with observation. Now listen to what he said to them in verse number 21. He said, first, the kingdom of Elohim cometh not with observation. So do not be deceived. Somebody tells you that it is there. No. Now what does he say? What does Yahushua say in verse number 21? He said, neither shall they say, lo there or lo here? For behold, the kingdom of Elohim is within you. So do not be deceived that the kingdom of Elohim is somewhere else. Remember and understand, Zion, that the kingdom of Elohim is within you. It is within you. Do not be deceived by these people. Do not be deceived by these people, because they would do everything within their reach to be able to do what? To desert you from not even thinking of or understanding the magnitude of the meaning of this word of Yahushua. Now, when he said that the kingdom is within you, he is letting you know that you have the power to establish, that the power to establish the kingdom, to make this kingdom shine forth through you, the power to do that is in you. The power that he possesses is also in you. So you don't need to be looking at any other person to be able to bring no kingdom from you. For you, the kingdom that you are seeking is already in you. All you need to do is to be able to do what? To let that kingdom do what? Shine through you. He said that what? Lo, the kingdom is within you. Now, what is that kingdom? Listen and understand. What is that kingdom of Elohim? Justice. What is that kingdom of Elohim? Equity. What is that kingdom of Elohim? You know, truthfulness. What is that kingdom of Elohim? You know, you can name them. Fairness, right? Now, how do you think that that word, the word of the wicked, would allow you to be able to establish this? So this is why the negativities, this is why the whole plans, this is why those particular negative energies has to push on, because they despise truth. Because they despise. Do you really understand why the head of John the Baptist was being chopped off? Because he exposed the atrocities that was being going on, that was going on in the kingdom of darkness. And they did not want it. They did not want it. They did not want it. He exposed the one that he exposed, yet he is pointing at somebody who is way more higher than he is. And that person is going to even, which is Yahushua, blew them and threw the kingdom of darkness into another abyss by exposing the atrocities which they are doing. And the children of those people are going to try to continue the work, the things which they are, you know, which has been started by Yahushua. And this is why they are against the truth. They are against you. They don't want you to be able to do what? To continue. They want to fight against you. They want to do everything within their reach. This is what you need to be able to understand, my dear brothers and sisters. The Bible said that, deliver thyself, O Zion, that lives in the midst of what? Of Babylon. You are being planted over there in different places for a reason. The time is now for you to be able to begin your work and not to be dependent on what? On the circular things which has already been taught by the same construct which is being made by what? By the daughter of Babylon. You got to be able to do what? To allow the Ruach to be able to give you a nourished spiritual food which would help you in order to fight against those unseen forces, because you possess a power that is unseen. The Bible says his truth is your shield and buckler. You understand what that means? The Bible says his truth, Yahushua's truth, the Father Yahushua's truth is your shield and buckler. There shall no arrow that is being thrown that come against that shall harm you. You understand what it means to have the truth as your shield and buckler? It's because you know. That is why the Bible said, because you have made Yahuwah, which is my refuge, thy habitation, therefore will I satisfy thee and show you my salvation. In the midst of all this, the enemies are planning things because they want to keep the power within the third dimensional paradigm recycled over and over and over and over again. But we are here to be able to tell you the word, to speak the word to you so that it will liberate you. So that through that word, you would have the power, the spiritual power. You will have the spiritual energy to deliver thyself, O Zion. Come out of her, my people. They use religion to brainwash so many of you. They use religion to be able to brainwash so many of you, so that you cannot even reason or think or understand the scripture itself. This is why you have to be able to really understand and know that you're dependent to the reality or the interpretation of the scripture should not be given to you through the secular means of 501c3 knowledge or the seminary, the school of theology or whatsoever. because all these structures are working towards the same structure that was being made in order to keep people under the cycle, being recycled over and over again. The Bible said, deliver thyself, deliver your mind, deliver your spirit, deliver your soul. Come out of her. They used religion of Catholicism against you. They used it in order to hold so many of you. Can you see the magnitude of what is really going on? The level of souls that are being sucked into what? Into Catholicism. The level of souls that are wandering, that are being swallowed out of their ignorance, out of their negligence, into idolatry, into the worship of Virgin Maria. This is the dark world that keeps on recycling people. And those people who are under the chains of these people, they cannot deliver themselves because they are bound. They are under the shackles of what? Of that dark world. The Bible said, deliver thyself, O Zion, that lives in the midst of what? Of Babylon. You are in the midst. What has Catholicism, I do worshiping God, to do with your spiritual being? What has Semiramis? What has the Virgin Maria of an idol that you people molded, that your people are bowing to, got to do with your liberation? How come you are bowing down to a molding image? A molten image of a Roman Catholic idols. Did you understand the magnitude of what is really going on? And people are being blindfolded, and yet you want to run to the Holy See in order for the Holy See to help you get your freedom, when these are the same people, the so-called Holy See, when these are the same people who are against your rise. They are the same people who are working hard in order to prevent you from rising up from your sleep and slumberness. They want to keep people recycled within their thought, because the more people they keep on recycling within the third dimensional paradigm, the more energy they suck out of them. So this is why you got to be able to do what? To deliver thyself. They have your people looking up. When you forgot, they have your people looking up, not looking inside of you where the real kingdom of Elohim is. The Bible says that your body is the temple of the living Elohim. Understand that. The Father sent Yahushua, Yahushua sent you. As the Father has sent Yahushua, so the Yahushua has sent you. When Yahushua was manifested on earth, there was no need for the Father to be manifested. And now you are being manifested here. There is no need that Yahushua to be manifested, because his word is in you. If you live in him, the same way that he lives in the Father, understand it. So you have the power and authority of Yahushua to establish that kingdom on earth. You got to deliver thyself, O Zion. But you have religion trying to tell you to be looking up, to be waiting for the coming, when the coming is already in you, when the word is already in you. You need to be able to understand what is really going on, and the way that everything was already being connected, my dear brothers and sisters, already. The establishment of the kingdom of heaven is going to be done on earth, right? And that kingdom of heaven is going to be done on earth. But then you see how Catholicism tells you that you are going to go into rapture. Getting the word and twisting it upside down. I tell you, they see good, they call it evil, and they see evil, they call it good. The establishment of the kingdom of heaven is going to be on earth. As it is in the heaven, so be on earth, right? But they are telling you that you are going back into the heaven, they are going to rapture you. And that is where they rapture you, that they are going to be going and having whatsoever marriage supper in the air. This is what they tell you, they fly you away. They fly you, or whatsoever fly you away, when Yahushua, when the Bible said that the kingdom is coming on earth. And that kingdom is already within you. So you got to just let that word shine. You got to let that kingdom shine. And in order for you, how is that going to happen? It's not going to happen because you are going to through you begging them. No, you are going to. It's going to happen because you have to take it by force. You understand what is really going on? It is going to happen because you got to take what belongs to you by force. if you have a united country of those people of that mindset, those people they don't need to apply for no any other one to the third world, to any world, in order for them to have an approval from them. But they take what belongs to them by right. They take what they establish, what belongs to them by right. They establish that word which they need to establish. Because the kingdom is within you. Because the kingdom is within you. And we need to be able to really see and understand the magnitude of what is really going on. Because the enemy is working hard in order to dumbfound, in order to blindfold so many people so that they can see. They use religion as a very big means of instrument to blindfold so many people, more especially Catholicism. Catholicism is a worst nightmare to a lot of people. And it has held and trapped so many people down. And that is the reason why we're here, in order to liberate those who are under the circle, who are under the chains of this world, of this dark world, who can no longer use their mind, because the same people that you are under, the same religion that you are under, is the same thing which was being used to deceive you. Used to corner your mind. Used for you not to be able to reason with your common sense, if it is common at all. It is time to wake up of your sleep and slumberness. Now listen to what the Bible says in the book of Micah chapter number 5 from verse number 8. Now we want to read this particular passage of the scripture. Micah chapter number 5 verse number 8. I want us to read what the Bible said there. Now listen to what the Bible says right there, because I love this particular passage so much. Now listen to what the Bible says here. It says, "And the remnant of Jacob shall be among the Gentiles in the midst of many people." Now you understand the magnitude of what I'm telling you? Did you understand? Did you grasp what I'm just trying to make you understand, my dear brothers and sisters out there? The children of Zion. These things they will not tell you, people. You are in the midst of Babylon, planted over there. They know who you are in those particular places where you are being planted. But they got to do what they got to do in order to keep you people blind. They got to do under their own oath and conspiracy. They are being bound under an oath and conspiracy not to reveal the secret of who you are to you, so they can continue manipulating over you. They can continue sucking the energy out of you. They can continue taking everything that they have, they can lay their hand on. They can continue doing all what they want to do with you, as long as you are blind under their own system. Now listen to what the Bible say. Right now that you are in the midst of those damn Babylon, they know this passage which I'm trying to read to you right now, my dear brothers and sisters out there. It said, "And the remnant of Jacob shall be in the midst of many, in the midst among the shall be among the Gentiles," talking about Babylon, "in the midst of many people." And then the Bible says, "As a lion among the beasts of the forest, as a young lion among the flock of sheep, who if he goes through, both tread it down and tear it in pieces, and none can deliver." Now, this is something that you need to be able to understand. Now, when you understand the power that you are being made up of, if you understand the components, if you understand the power that Yahushua made you with, if you understand that the authority that Yahushua builds you up with, if you are a big threat, I'm telling you, they are going to rush and fight against, they are going to come against you the way they fought against Yahushua. They are going to come against you the way they fought against John the Baptist. They are going to come after you, because you know why. But you know, though they come in a thousand ways, you're going to come out flying color. That is why the Bible said, "Though 1,000 at my side and 10,000 at my right hand side, they shall not come near me." But if it is coming, they are going to come with their own trials. You see the way that those scribes, Pharisees, elders of the people, and all those them people we are just coming, rushing and trying to be able to go against what Yahushua was saying. They know what you are up to. They know what the mission is. They know what the sick. They don't want to let go those things which are under their power. Catholicism is afraid of the rise of the children of Zion. Catholicism is afraid of the rise of the children of Zion. You got to deliver thyself, O Zion, that lives among the daughters of Babylon. They know this, that when you rise, you are like a lion among the flock of sheep. When he goes through, ain't nobody who is going to tame you. Ain't nobody who is going to tame you. Ain't nobody who is going to tame you, my dear brothers and sisters out there. I'm speaking the words of wisdom to those people who have ears to hear. My brothers and sisters, I say to you all, may you all remember, Baruch, we're going to continue on this particular study as time goes on. And we say, you know, may the name of our Heavenly Father, whose name is Yahuwah, through Yahushua be exalted. And may his word speak in the life of each and every one of you. And may the interpretation of the word be given and the higher revelation be given to each and every one that has listened to this particular word. And may the word bear fruit in their lives. And may it be a testimony, I decree, in the name of Yahushua. I say to you all, my dear brothers and sisters out there, may you all remain Baruch in the name of Yahushua. I am freedom, and the freedom is in you. You shall be free. Thou shalt know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. You, the truth, shall make you free. Shalom, my dear brothers and sisters out there. Shalom to you all. Shalom, shalom.